and welcome to our session. Let us discuss the following question. The question says, solve the following inequality graphically in two-dimensional plane. Given an equation is 3y minus 5x less than 13. Before solving this question, we should know that a line divides the Cartesian plane into two half planes, and graph of inequality will be one of the half planes. We shall show the solution by shading in the corresponding half plane. We have learned the rules which are used to identify the half plane represented by an inequality. According to the first rule, we have to take any point AB not on line, and then we have to check whether it satisfies the inequality or not. If the point satisfies the inequality, then the inequality represents that particular half plane containing the point. But if the point not satisfies the inequality, then the other half plane represents the solution. And according to the second rule, if sign of equality is also there with inequality, then the line is included in the solution region, and so we draw a dark line. And according to the last rule, if we have a pure inequality, then the points on the corresponding line are not included in the solution region, and so we draw a dotted line. Keeping all these rules in mind, let's now begin with the solution. Given an equation is 3y minus 5x is less than 30. Now, equation corresponding to this inequality is 3y minus 5x equals to 0. Now, we will find two solutions of this equation. Put y equals to 0. Now, when y is equal to 0, then x is equal to minus 6. And when x is equal to 0, then y is equal to 10. So, the two solutions of this equation are minus 6, 0 and 0, 10. Now, we will plot these two points on the graph. So, let's make a graph now. Now, the two points which we have to plot are 0, 10 and minus 6, 0. Now, the first point is 0, 10. This means when abscissa is 0, then ordinate is 10. This is the point 0, 10. Second point is minus 6, 0. This means when ordinate is 0, then abscissa is minus 6. This is the point minus 6, 0. Now, according to the last rule, we know that if we have a pure inequality, then the points on the corresponding line are not included in the solution region, and so we draw a dotted line. Now, here the given inequality is 3y minus 5x is less than 30. We have a pure inequality here, so we will draw a dotted line to join these two points, and this line will not be included in the solution region. This is the line 3y minus 5x equals to 30. Now, this line is dividing this plane into two half planes, that is first and second. Now, we have to identify the half plane represented by the given inequality. According to the first rule, we have to take any point AB not on the line, and then we have to check whether it satisfies the inequality or not. If the point satisfies the inequality, then the inequality represents that particular half plane containing the point. But if the point not satisfies the inequality, then the other half plane represents the solution. Now we will identify the half plane represented by the given inequality. According to the first rule, we know that we have to take any point AB not on the line, and then we have to check whether it satisfies the inequality or not. If the point satisfies the inequality, then the inequality represents that particular half plane containing the point. But if the point not satisfies the inequality, then the other half plane represents the solution. Now, as the point 0, 0 does not lie on the line, 3y minus 5x equals to 0. So, we will take the point as 0, 0. on substituting x as 0 and y as 0, we get 0 less than 30, which is true. Hence, the half plane containing zero zero represents the inequality three y minus five x less than 30. The graph. First half plane contains the point 0, 0. So this means this is the required solution region. And in this solution region, this line will not be included as we have pure inequality. So let's now shade this region. This is the required graphical solution of the given inequality. Therefore, the shaded half plane first excluding the line is the required graphical solution. This is our required answer. So this completes the session. Bye and take care.